episode 1378, What Your Anger May Be Hiding.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Aloha and happy day. It is Friday. You made it through the week. Can you believe it? The weekend is here, and you get a chance to breathe. Oh my goodness, I am ready to go to the beach. Okay, I'm not in Hawaii now, but I just wanted to make you feel like you were there. I want you to feel comfortable because we're talking about a difficult situation. It's Confessions of an Upset Mama. What Your Anger May Be Hiding. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already even had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, what your anger may be hiding will surprise you. When you get mad, what are you really mad about? You most likely are experiencing something much deeper. Unfortunately, though, we suppress our real feelings and convince ourselves that the only way to survive the situation is to be angry. Sound all too familiar? Well, our children can act out the same way. We think they are being ridiculous and unruly. You remember that conversation. Maybe you just had it yesterday. And you're like, gosh, what has gotten into this girl of mine? I don't get it. But in actuality, they are simply asking for help with all the wrong emotions. Come on, Mom. Come on, Dad. Listen up here. They're simply asking for what? Help. But they don't know how to do it. They haven't been taught. And most of us were not taught. We don't think about our emotions, right? Instead, we just get mad and we get angry. Our children, well, they don't know how to handle their feelings and everything that is happening within their bodies. So out with the anger. It's just a lashing. And it's an easy cover-up, honestly. We get mad right back at them, don't we? And the conversation ends with some yelling and eventually shutting down. No one's speaking until, well, maybe you get an I'm sorry, and maybe you don't. You just go on. And here you have this situation that boiled up and you really don't know what's really going on. When you find yourself yelling for no reason, getting upset because, well, you don't really know or remember why, your anger may be hiding something much deeper. This is a huge, huge wake-up call when it comes to our children and how we help them understand life. It's a huge wake-up call for ourselves. So today, when you're listening to this, I want you to put yourself, if you have children, think about your conversations recently with your children. Even if they're two, did you know a two-year-old can chew someone out just as much as a 12-year-old or a 22-year-old? Yeah, age doesn't matter. They can be 92 and you can still get chewed out. May sound a little bit different, but you're still getting chewed out. So when we're talking about this, I want you to put yourself in a recent situation. And then I also want you to look at it as in, okay, how do I handle this as an individual? Because we need to help our children understand life. And that includes what? Our feelings. If we let our own feelings take over, anger will win every time. Every time, just turn on the news. That's all I'm going to say. It's proof enough. We see it. We hear it in our communities. We see it when we turn on the television. This is stuff that, why is it even happening? Well, because we don't talk about it anymore. No one knows or has stopped long enough. Parents are both working, or it's a single parent raising children, and so they're not around. And we just have this kind of overflow of emotions that no one wants to deal with, and it's called we're just getting by. But the problem is we're sacrificing each other for just getting by. And that also means you're sacrificing your family. You can't give up your family. It's God-given. You can choose your friends, but you can't choose your family. God chose it for you. So we have to begin to work and understand our feelings before anger takes over and wins every time. And when it does that, nothing will be solved, right? And you'll be right back where you started. You mad at yourself, angry at your child, and then frustrated because you don't know really what's going on. Your child will be angry too. Nothing will change. You know, raising children with sound emotions is a challenge. I know, I have 5 of them, and they are all so different. And I love that, but it challenges me. As a mom, as a woman, as a female, I have conversations in my head that if you were in my head and you could hear these conversations, you'd be like, whoa, I didn't know you could go down that road. Oh, God blessed me with 5, but he challenged me. And he challenged me not only for me to help them, but for them to help me. Reverse. It's very important. That's why this episode, Confessions of an Upset Mama, it's what kids can what? Teach us as parents as at the same time that we are trying to teach them. So raising children, yeah, with sound emotions, it is a challenge. Dealing with our own is difficult. Did you know anger can be self-defense, empowering, and soothing? You're like, whoa, I never thought of anger as being all of those. Well, let's look at it. Anger can be self-defense, you standing up for what you believe in. Somebody tells you something, you disagree with them, and all of a sudden you're barking down their throat, yelling at them. Not really yelling, but maybe you're raising your voice a little bit, getting a little bit louder. So it seems, you know, intensified compared to your normal conversation. And all of a sudden you're in full self-defense mode. You're in battle. Well, that can be a good thing if you're standing up for what you believe in, but it can also be a very bad thing at the same time. Anger can be empowering. Empowering should be positive. Anger's not positive. But when it does empower us, it's because what? We think we're bigger than what happened. When it empowers you, you think you're bigger than what happened to you. And anger can be soothing. It makes you feel what? Like you're in control. We all like control. Because when we have control, we think that all is going to be okay. But when we begin to tread on water and it begins to get rocky and we can't handle it and we feel out of control, what happens? Anxiety, fear, all this stuff just comes thrusting at us. So honestly, anger can what? It can soothe us. Not that any of these are correct, but the results of what anger gives a person is attractive. And so that's our go-to. If I don't like it, I'm going to be angry. If I don't get what I want, I'm going to be angry. It all goes back to anger. It makes you feel in control when ultimately you are out of control. So we have to find a way to blend or harmonize our emotions with the circumstances. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Harmonize your emotions with your circumstances. There's something more to this. That's ultimately what you're looking at. It's not about the anger, because yes, they're your emotions, but there's something more to this. Our emotions allow us to release energy, good or bad. Think about a baby. A baby doesn't speak. It can't say, okay, my head hurts, or I'm hungry, or I have a wet diaper. All they know is that I've got this feeling and I got to get it out. And so they cry. They yell. They scream. Sometimes they kick. That's because they can't walk. But it's their way of what? Releasing energy. Our emotions allow us to do that because we get this flood of what? Our blood pressure goes up. Think about the last time you were angry. If you can remember that, maybe it was with your husband, maybe it was with a child, maybe it was with your boss, maybe it was with yourself and you're standing in front of the mirror and you're so mad. What were you actually feeling on the inside? What was your body doing? Did you feel like you were getting hot? Your blood pressure was increasing. I mean, physically, did you begin kind of to sweat? And no, it wasn't a hot flash. What was it that you were in the middle of feeling when this emotion of anger and you just wanting to bite somebody's head off trapped you? What was it? Because our emotions really allow us to release the energy. And they can be really great. If you can take that feeling and turn it into what? Something productive. And that's what we need to talk about, because there's something more to this. So let's break it down as to what it means to harmonize your emotions with your circumstances. Number one, acknowledge your feelings. You don't want to bury this stuff, because what happens? If you're burying stuff that's especially bad, it's going to lead to depression, more frustration, eventually what? Bitterness. It can lead to loneliness. There's so many things that it can go down the wrong rabbit hole. You don't want to go there. So you've got to acknowledge your feelings. If you're listening to your child spout off in anger, you don't respond back in anger. That's important. Because why? There's something more to this. When they're yelling at you after school, they get in and you ask them, hey, how was your day? Oh, I don't know. It was just blah. And then all of a sudden you're like, oh my gosh, what happened? Don't sit there and start yelling back. What is that accomplishing? Nothing. And we've all done it. I've done it. Confession. I've done it too many times. But it doesn't get you anywhere. There's something more to this. So when it's happening, let them just acknowledge their feelings. That's what they're doing. You can even encourage by asking them questions about, well, how did that make you feel? What was it about that situation you didn't like? Ask those probing questions. For yourself, same too. Acknowledge your feelings. Know that this is how you feel. Yeah, maybe your husband is leaving the toilet lit up all the time. In the bathroom. Here we are in the bathroom again. Okay, I'm sorry. We always end up in the bathroom or the kitchen, don't we? Okay, so we're back in the bathroom again. And your husband's leaving it up. And you're mad. Okay, acknowledge that that upsets you. Acknowledge that gets underneath. But is there more to it than just that? Is there more than that toilet lid being up? Because see, that's ultimately where you want to go. You want to know the deeper meaning of all of this. But you do have to acknowledge your feelings. Very important. Number two, direct your actions separate from your emotions, meaning that your emotions don't dictate your actions. Just because you're mad doesn't mean you get to go hit a wall. Just because your child did something wrong and you're mad at them doesn't mean that you get to go spank the living tar out of them. No, no, and no. Direct your actions, which means what? You are making an actual decision, committing to the next step to move you forward. It's not about, oh, well, I feel like doing this. I'm mad, so I'm going to put my, hand into a wall, or I'm going to kick something, or I'm going to throw a plate down, or I'm going to throw my water bottle, or I'm going to throw my hat, or I'm going to slam on the brakes because I'm just mad. Come on, you can go there. I know you've been there. We've all been there. But the thing is, you don't want to keep going back there. So you want to direct your actions separate from your emotions. And you can do that because why? You've already acknowledged your feelings. You get it. And when you're talking about your child, you've let your child acknowledge their feelings. They may need a little bit of a breather. And then you can help them what? Take the next step. Direct their actions. What would be wise for you to do here? Yes, I know you were mad. You didn't get what you wanted out of this situation. But what's a better response? What needs to be your next step? Do you see how you can direct and help direct their actions? Same with your own. And finally, number three, respond in forgiveness and in love. This is moving you forward. It's not about your feelings. It's about your direction. It's about your focus. It's about your purpose. Respond in forgiveness and in love. You see, there's something more to this. When we get so upset, when we get entangled with this anger, this boiling up within ourselves, where our blood pressure just feels like we're a cartoon and our head's going to pop off and smoke's going to come out. I know you felt that because I felt it, especially with children. When you're trying to take care of them, when you're trying to sit there and explain something to them, when you're trying to calm down a totally crazy situation, maybe it's just a sibling fight within your own house. They're just yelling and going at it and they're just bickering at each other and they've been doing it for the last 20 minutes and you've told them 500 times, and that's not exaggerating, enough is enough is enough. And they're still going at it. Next thing you know, everybody's heads are blowing off, right? It reminds you of that cartoon. We feel that way, but we don't want to talk about it because I don't know why. We're too embarrassed. We don't think, oh, no one will understand me. Oh, maybe I'll be that bad parent. No, we need to talk about it so we can deal with it. We got to harmonize our emotions with our circumstances. We've got to find that blend. What makes it work? And when you acknowledge your feelings, you direct your actions, then you respond in forgiveness and in love. And that allows you what? If you're in a circumstance where it's a mad portion of it based on someone else and you're directing your anger more towards them, then when you respond in forgiveness, then you're letting it go. When you respond in love, that means you're serving, whether you're serving yourself, you're serving the person that maybe you hurt or they hurt you. It's a different response. And it allows you to move forward and put the bad, the yuck, the muck, whatever came at you that you were so mad about behind you. It's done. It's in the past. And now you can move forward. But you see, a lot of us just hang on what? To our feelings. And we don't get any further than that. Yeah, we acknowledge that we're mad. And then we stay mad. And we go to our little bank account and we insert our little card that says, I'm mad at you. Cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching. Next time comes around, oh, I'm mad at you. Cha-ching. And pretty soon you have this account of I'm mad at you. I can't stand you. You make me feel this way. And it doesn't lead to anything good. And your child watches you. And they do the same thing. We continually produce what we do. So if your child is watching what you do, they're going to do the same thing. Why? Because they were raised by you. So we have to be those role models. Yep, that means it puts a lot of responsibility on us. But it doesn't stop at just acknowledging our feelings. We're so good at it. We like to keep score. I love football. Football's a game that you want to keep score at because there's going to be a winner. But when you're keeping score on every single time you're hurt, you're only going to stay in pain the rest of your life. And that's a pretty drastic statement to make. But it's one that I've seen. It's one I've coached women and men on. It's ones that I've been counseled on. If you harbor all of this anger and you're keeping score of it, it's only going to keep you in pain. And you'll never get to number two and number three. And it's going to eat at you and tear you apart. It's going to do the same with your child. And then they're going to go into their relationships and they're going to have their family and they're going to eventually become you. Is that what you want? You see, there's something more to this. What your anger may be hiding. What is it for real? I want to challenge you today. I know it's kind of heavy on a Friday. I get it. But we deal with real stuff here, don't we, at Create Your Now. This is not about, oh, it's going to be happy, positive, everything. Oh, I believe in that completely. But I also believe in real life because real life happens. And it's not about this perfect life that we live because none of us live a perfect life. We live a perfect, imperfect life. But when we can do it together and help each other grow, that's what makes it incredible. So you can create your now. But I want to challenge you today as you go about just kind of thinking about things in your mind, the next time you feel upset, angry, or hostile with yourself or someone else, maybe your child is having an issue. Maybe when you pick them up from school today, they're, you know, mad because of something. Maybe you've got Friday football happening in your household and your child is in the band or is on the football team or is on the cheerleading squad or dance squad, whatever. Maybe your child just loves football and they just go to the game to support their friends. But something happened. And all of a sudden, you've got this whole tension created here of anger. Ask yourself the question, what is my anger hiding? And if it involves your child, after they express their feelings, you want to listen to them. They need to. We all need to acknowledge our feelings. Bring them down to a level and say, hey, sweetie, I want you to ask yourself this question. What is it about my anger? What am I really upset about? Let him chew on that for a moment. You chew on it for a moment. See if there's not something more to this. Anger is a hard thing. I know I dealt with it personally. It's something that can tear a family apart. It broke down my marriage. One of many things. You are not ever going to be perfect. No matter how much money you spend on counseling, coaching, no matter how much you go to the doctors, the psychologists, psychiatrists, no matter how many times you go to church, you could go every single day and you're still going to have issues. It's part of life. But you see, when we allow our anger to get out of control, where it becomes a part of our daily being, there we have issues. And that's not a way to live. It's not good for the children. It's not good for your health and your well-being. And it's definitely not good for your marriage and your relationships in life. So if you're one who truly struggles with anger, or you have children who are acting out and you just don't know really how to help them, but you know there's this underlining factor called anger, click on the link, take aim in the show notes. I have a free gift for you. It's a coaching call with me. I truly understand the anger part. I lived it. But I also got help for it. You do not want anger to destroy the life that God wants you to have, but you have to be willing to change. Click on that link, take aim in the show notes, and that will begin our conversation. We'll get you set up for a coaching call with me. I'm here for you. It's my gift. Take advantage of it today. You matter. You don't have to be angry anymore at life. Your household doesn't have to be a war zone. Let's change it today. You know, when I was writing this episode, I really wasn't sure where it was going to go. I usually don't know. Sometimes I'll come up with a title or sometimes I'll have a story. It just depends on the situation and circumstances. And this one, I just kind of let myself write. It was really a conglomerate of heart, soul, feelings, and faith. We've got to understand that we're not going to be perfect until we get to heaven. And your time, I pray, is not now, because God has a lot more in store for you here on earth. He's training you up. But you have to be willing to take those steps, and it can be so daggum challenging. But I promise you, it is worth all the effort. Don't let your anger run your life, because it will ruin it. It will destroy it. You matter. What your anger may be hiding is that there's something more to this. Take that challenge today. Look at it. Ask that question. And instead, take your anger and forgive and live and love. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. Have a wonderful weekend. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.